I'm here to present a topic on taxonomic update of African stickless bees using molecular method. This is part of my Commonwealth Fellowship in University College, London. Stickless bees abound in Nigeria, and they have come in very close association with human beings. The first picture I'm showing you here is the nest of a stickless bee on a window in a human building. And followed by that is another nest on a tree trunk. And another one is, you can see another nest here on a brick wall. And we have another one here on a door frame into a human being's entrance. And we also have another one here on the electrical fittings of a building. Why they abound in Nigeria have come into close contact with human beings, only few people know about the stingless bees. But those in microbiology are interested in the antimicrobial activity of the honey the stingless bees produced. And those are also in agricultural economies have interest in the economics of, that is the market value of the different honeys made by stingless bees. But for accurate scientific communication, the taxonomy of the stingless bees or their identification has to be known, so that one can effectively communicate the scientific community on the particular species he or she is working on. So the stingless bees perform several functions, which include pollination. They are known to pollinate crop plants. Also, they produce honey, which is used as food. And in addition, the honey has medicinal value and has been found to have antimicrobial activity and even perform better than the standard antibiotics in microbial inhibition. And the ecosystem, the stingless bees can also serve as food for some other entomophagous animals. In Africa, 6 genera of stingless bees has been described by Edley 2004, and include the Dactylorhina, Meliponula, Plebeiana, Hypotrigona, and the Leotrigona. But Edley synonymized the genera Meliponula and the Axisterigona. You can see Axisterigona on the right. However, scientists and many authors have used the two different generic names. Some authors use Meliponula and some authors use Axisterigona, especially in Africa. So, and to have a uniform communication concerning these species, we now want to look at the status of the two generic names, whether they are synonyms or not, because the synonymization was based on morphological features. Also, then, the Edley stressed the need to include molecular data involving DNA barcoding to update the taxonomy of African stingless bees and to resolve the critic variation among the groups. And these are some two of the contending issues in the taxonomy of stingless bees. You can see the two, one here is brown and one is black. Then, and two of them are described as Meliponula ferruginea, with the other one known as reddish brown and the other one known as black. But in the course of our collection, we looked at the behavior, although I don't report it here, we looked at the behavior, the nest, and so many authors have also looked at the behavior, the nesting structure, and found the two to be different. So, and the morphology of them are different. You can see the picture of the nest. This is a situation where both the Mofo species had their nest on a prefab building inside University of Nigeria, Nsukka. So we studied a series of nests and found out that the nests are different both on the length of the entrance and the number guarding the nest and the nesting sites. So we now have the question, are the two Mofo species the same or different? Then we now designed our objective of the study. One, to resolve the species status of the two Mofo species, the black and the reddish brown. And also to determine the generic status of the two genera, the Meliponula and the Axisterigona. Then we now collected Meliponula stingless bees across Nigeria from the northern part and the southern part. And after collection, we subjected, first of all, subjected to morphological identification using taxonomic keys. And after using taxonomic keys, we also took the samples to Natural History Museum UK, where we compare them with type and a vulture specimen to confirm the identity of the species. Then after that, we now proceeded to the molecular methods. And the first we use is the DNA barcoding. So you know, morphological identification has so many limitations. So it is always being complemented using molecular methods or integrated with some other molecular morphology and a behavioral method. But here we test only the molecular methods. So we extracted DNA from the samples and amplified the CO1 gene as the barcode region of the CO1 gene using Barbie primer developed by Frankus and Arias 2014. And the choice of the primer is that this primer do not amplify contaminants or that is a pseudogene or norms when they are present. So we sequenced them and analyzed the sequence data. And in the results, you can see this is a phylogenetic, the maximum likelihood tree generated using the CO1 gene. If you look at the phylogenetic tree, you can see that the Meliponula region are the brown, clustered differently from that of Meliponula ferruginea black. Then, and we also subjected the sequences of the two morpho species to automatic barcode gap discovery, in which a barcode gap of more than 3% indicates a different species, but less than 3% indicates same species. But when we are subjected to automatic barcode gap discovery, we found a barcode gap of 7%, which is still pointing out to the differences observed in the morphological features. And looking at this phylogenetic tree, you can also see the red dots here. You can see this is the branch bearing the Meliponula. And you can also see the down bearing Meliponula bocandei. And looking at this species, the generic placement, you can see that they are separated on the phylogenetic tree by hypotrigonal gripodoi and the dactylurina strandigeri. This separation of the Meliponula ferruginea and the Meliponula bocandei has been found by some other authors that use molecular method and the morphological method to construct phylogenetic tree. So our question now is this Meliponula and this also Meliponula, since they are separated apart in the phylogenetic tree? We now decided to move ahead to check out some other gene regions which have been found to be robust in the construction of phylogeny in bees. Then our objective still remains the same, which is the resolving the morpho species status of the two, the black and the brown, and also testing the Meliponula and Axitrigona status. Then we amplified and sequenced the elongation factor, that is a total of 1,100 base pairs and the 28S gene. The primers and the method employed in the phylogeny was according to Martins et al. 2014. And when we did that, we consulted the phylogenetic tree also, and we observed that in the phylogenetic tree, the two morpho species still remained different. They clustered differently. So you can see the Meliponula ferruginea brown clustering different from a Meliponula ferruginea black. And also, you can still see that the Meliponula and Meliponula are separated on the phylogenetic tree by species in other genus, in the genera Leotrigona and the Hypotrigona. This is for elongation factor. Then we also did that for the 28S gene, and we also observed the same thing. You can see the molecular ferruginea brown clustering different from Meliponula ferruginea black. And looking at the two morpho species, looking at the generic placement, Vanda Moliponula Bocande and Molecular Ferruginia are still separated by eutrigona and the hypotrigona. So on this note, we now raised it with the Natural History Museum, and based on this study, we have come to the conclusion that one, that the genera Meliponula and the Azes terigona are not synonyms, but each a valid generic name. So the Meliponula bocandei retained the genus Meliponula because the type specimen of Meliponula is Meliponula bocandei. Why the Mofo species, which have been referred to Meliponula, especially in Africa, retains the name Azes terigona. And in the Natural History Museum, where we compare the type and vulture specimen, the names in the Natural History Museum is Azes terigona. So in the two Mofo species, the brown one retains Azes terigona ferruginea, why we are proposing a new name for the black Mofo species, which we name the Azes terigona nigerrima. Nigerrima is a Latin name meaning black. So because the body color is the obvious distinction between the two Mofo species. So the black one can be referred to as nigerrima, but we are still preparing other data to make it a holistic, because studies from nesting sites, nest entrance, nest structure, behavior, morphology, and molecular have shown that these two Mofo species are different. So I want to acknowledge the Sumner Lab University College London for hosting my Commonwealth Fellowship and all the other members of the lab that helped me during the fellowship. I also want to acknowledge the Commonwealth Scholarship Commission for sponsoring this research. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Akim. Getting a lot of applause.
Oh, thank you. I think we have only time for one question. So the question is, do the two, but you name them differently now. Okay, so do the two
species,
species occur?